They're all in. And there away, Rodrigo de Triano just dwelt a tiny bit in the stalls, and going on in the early stages, Zahi with Beldi in the early stages. Zahi on the inside of Beldi, then comes Azoud, then brief truce on the outside, Castadou's just in behind them. Rodrigo de Triano is the back marker. River falls, two from last and one from last to Razi. And still Zahi. Zahi making it from on the outside Beldi, tucked in behind is Azoud, big truce on the outside, Castadou comes next, then Arazi, then River Falls, and then Rodrigo de Triano, the back marker, as they race now towards the 5 furlong marker. And Zahi still the leader from Beldi. Behind Beldi is Azoud, and then brief truce on the outside, Castadou, then Arazi, River Falls, and Rodrigo de Triano. Half a mile from home now, and as they do, as they pass the half mile pole, it's Zahi the leader from Beldi. Behind Beldi is Azoud, then brief truce, then Castadou. Arazi poised just in behind Castadou. Rodrigo de Triano still last as they swing into the home stretch now with 2.5 furlongs to run, and it's Zahi the leader from Azoud. Then comes Beldi on the outside, brief truce, Castadou putting in a good run, Arazi's been swept to the outside, Rodrigo de Triano also, it's Zahi in the lead over on the far rails, here comes Rodrigo de Triano towards the stand side under the spigot, over on the far side, Zahi, but Rodrigo de Triano finishing fast on the near side, Zahi as they race up towards the line from brief truce and Rodrigo, and brief truce and Zahi have passed it together from Azoud and Rodrigo de Triano and Arazi. It's a photo finish between Zahi on the far side and brief truce on the near side. A dramatic climax to this St. James's Palace Stakes, with the judge calling for a photo between brief truce number 3, owned by Moyglare Stud Farms, trained by Dermot Weldon Ireland and ridden by Michael Kinnane, and Zahi, owned by Sheikh Hamdan Al Maktoum, trained by Tom Jones and ridden by Richard Hills. And these two have ultimately distanced the remainder, with Azoud probably just third ahead of Rodrigo de Triano, who came with a run towards the stand side but who petered out very quickly inside the final furlong.
Well, what a race and what a disappointment, Arazi. Leicester comes into the straight last on Rodrigo de Triano, but for a moment it looked halfway up the straight as though he might do it. Zahi, who's forced the pace, still holding Azoud here. Beldi four from the left. Here comes brief truce on the outside. Arazi just flattered for a moment, but when Steve went for his whip, there was nothing in the locker. And then came Leicester, last and widest of all, and for a moment it looked as though he might pick up. He went past Arazi, but the others had a length and a half on him. Zahi's run with such terrific courage keeps battling away on the far side, but now this great big race jockey Michael Kinnane throws down his challenge on brief truce, blinkered for the first time today. The blinkers have helped him. Rodrigo's still got only half a length to make up in the last 150 yards, but he hasn't the resources to do it. Arazi's beaten here, and as the line gets closer, brief truce thrust his head in front just on the line from Zahi with Rodrigo de Triano third. Well, what a terrific race this was to watch, but you can see that Leicester has been forced 7 horses wide as they come to the 2 furlong marker. There was no point in trying to be clever here because there are a lot of horses in there with a chance. Left to right, Zahi, Azoud with a noseband, Castadou flattered for a moment, and also Michael Canaan's mount just possibly edging to the right a little bit there, brief truce, and Arazi. Well, Leicester didn't want to be taking liberties with Arazi, so he's come wide but has had to pull his whip through to in his left hand here because Rodrigo slightly over the cake. But it's the on the inside that the action's all happening, and Zahi with Richard Hills riding with his whip in his left hand faces one of the strongest finishers in the business in Michael Kinnane. Neck and neck they race to the line. Azoud hangs on in there with his hood. Leicester looks over and knows that he's just got too much to do on Rodrigo. And in the end, it's the horses who finished third in the Irish 2000 and fourth in the French 2000 who come to beat the great Arazi and the dual classic winner. So the number